What is nuclear magnetic resonance? It has 100 different applications in science, but the most familiar one is probably an MRI scanner. MRI scanners use hydrogen nuclear magnetic resonance to capture the distribution of hydrogen atoms in the body, usually in the form of H2O molecules, or water. At Ames Laboratory, NMR is only a little bit different. Instead of exploring the human body, we use it to understand the chemical and physical properties of materials. By determining the structure of a material, we can then determine why it behaves the way it does, and then find ways to improve it.
Understanding a given material generally requires you to understand how the atoms are organized in the material. It's this atomic level structure that determines a lot of the interesting material properties, but determining this structure is often very challenging due to the extremely small scales, and that's where NMR comes in.
To understand NMR, you need to understand one basic concept. Atomic nuclei on the smallest scale have a magnetic pole, just like the Earth does. Some nuclei spin up, as scientists like to say, and some spin down, and tend to cancel each other out. NMR can get all of the nuclei magnetic fields to shift in one direction by using a very powerful magnet. This change is what scientists look for when they're performing experiments. Scientists can measure this change. How much energy did it take to alter the spin? How long did it take to return to its original energy level? Once scientists know this, they can map the structure and behavior that is unique to that material sample.
So because we're only looking at an infinitesimal portion of the sample, the sensitivity of NMR is quite low, and that limits the types of samples you can look at and the complexity of the experiments that you can perform. And that's where dynamic nuclear polarization really helps out.
Dynamic nuclear polarization works in a slightly different way. Instead of only relying on strong magnets, the molecules get helped out with non-harmful microwave radiation. This radiation forces more of the nuclei to rest at a lower energy level, so that when magnetic direction shifts, it's easier to detect.
DNP NMR allows scientists to perform a broader array of experiments and obtain richer data. And this is useful for the development of a wide array of materials, such as two-dimensional materials, semiconductor quantum dots, heterogeneous catalysts, and quantum materials.
NMR, DNP NMR, and other specialized techniques using these tools give scientists the ability to understand and improve materials that will be used to improve or invent future technologies, from biofuel conversion to quantum computing. And that's your Ames Lab 101.